Praise the Lord, amen. Praise the Lord. Welcome to Angels in Heaven, Redeeming Love Baptist Church. Another glorious day celebrating God's goodness and His words and His blessings, amen. Welcome to the service. God bless y'all, amen. Hope you enjoy the service as we take you in a good understanding to doctoring of the Word of God, amen. Hallelujah. If you live right, heaven belongs to you. Yes, amen. Welcome. Amen. Praise God. If you live right, heaven belongs to you.
Yeah. Amen. If you live right, heaven belongs to you.
We're going to have one more song, and then we'll have our hymn, and we'll have our message. Amen.
Rehoboth Church of God in Christ. I was invited to go to Italy. And I told the Lord, Lord, I want something special to see once I get there. As I was sitting, I was reading the passage of scripture that said, when you pray, enter into your closet. Your heavenly Father, which seeth in secret, he will reward you openly. So I went into the closet and I went prostrate before the Lord. And when I came out, this is what he gave me.
Praise the Lord, amen. Welcome, amen, to another service of
Angels in Heaven Redeeming Blood Baptist Church.
Praise with the Kroger app, you can get personalized coupons on top of weekly sales, all for prices that are lower than low. Kroger, fresh for everyone.
Are you a man with prostate cancer that hasn't spread to other parts of your body, whose PSA is rising despite hormone therapy? With Nubeqa, you may live more than 2 times longer.
Father God, we come to you, Lord, thank you for this day. Father God, we thank you for your grace and mercy. We ask you to bless the service. Bless the word. Bless the people that's about to go forth. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Praise God. Amen. Today,
before we begin, I want to bring us in with an old hymn. We're hearing about direction. And everybody knows God is direction. And God is my refuge, amen. And he is the savior of my life, amen. He is my fortress, my hope, and my strength. He is the lily in the valley. He is my everything that I need him to be. I look towards heaven and I say these words. You know right now. Bless you, bless each and every person. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Where could I go? Amen. Where could I go? We're dealing with two books today. We're going to go into the book of Proverbs, the third chapter, starting at the fifth verse. Proverbs, the third chapter, the fifth verse. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Let us move on to the book of John, the 16th chapter, the 13th verse. How about when he, the Spirit of the truth, is come, he will guide you to all truth, for he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he should hear, out shall he speak, and he will with me not things to come. Today I want to talk about, where should I go? Where should I go? Amen. So God is saying, well, I'm in the right direction. You got to get to me. So where should I go? Well, you see, a lot of times, as young people, myself being young, we get caught up in the wrong crowd as a person. We grew up in church all of our lives, then we leave the church because we feel like it's not where we should go. Amen. So, therefore, you feel like that God is not your refuge, that you're not seeking refuge, but God is your fortress and your strength. Amen. See, God said, I come so that you may have life and abundantly and above all things. So therefore, where should I go? You should go in the right direction, which God is, and not in the wrong direction, which Satan is. See, our flesh and our mind steer us in the wrong direction when we know God is trying to talk to us. Amen. So, therefore, you see, God is trying to tell us when you're going a certain direction, you have to listen and take heed to what I'm trying to tell you. It's like how our parents tell us something and we think we know it all, but we really don't. It's like how mother would say, don't go out to that place where you know they shoot up the place after midnight. Or auntie may say, baby girl, I need you to protect yourself when you out here having sex and you don't listen to her. Or she may say, uncle may say to nephew, I need you to take this precaution or procedure when you out here doing what you're doing and you know good and well you can't take care of no child. See, it's those orders that are being given by the elders, which we are not taking heed to. Because God is saying, well, he said, trust in the Lord with all thine heart. So therefore, if I'm going to let God lead me, I got to trust in God. But let's go in the book of John. See, the book of John said that, it said, how about when he, the Spirit of truth? So therefore, the Spirit of truth is God. But when God speaks, he ain't gonna speak against himself. He gonna speak to tell you what to do, what's right, not what's wrong. See, that's what a lot of people today. We feel like we don't need no direction in our life when we go astray, when we really need direction to keep us on the right path in life. So therefore, when we get the right direction, it gives us the straight path we could go. So when we get the straight direction, we get the order that is being given by Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. But the question is, are you really taking heed to the direction that God has given you? Well, a lot of folks say, I don't need to know God. You need to know God because where should you go depends on where should you go when you leave this earth. Amen. So therefore, where should I go symbolizes how I should want to stand, how I should want to do what's right, but to understand where God lies and lives in me. Amen. It's always a principle of the matter that you got to figure out where should you go. When you think about how somebody say you ain't gonna make it, but you gotta figure out the right direction. If you're trying to go on a road trip, you try to figure out where you go. But God said, no, come back and listen to me. I already told you in the beginning that if you trust in me, I'm gonna direct your path. Then I came back and said, I had John tell you that. I'm not going to speak against myself, but I'm going to speak the truth. So therefore, you got to know where you should go and where you should follow is determined by your direction that you take. Ooh, where you should go. Hallelujah. Where you should go. Where you should go. Well, sometime in your life you feel like you're down. You feel like you lost direction. You feel like you don't know where to go. You don't know where to turn. But Jesus is the right direction. Well, Jesus died on Calvary. When he died on Calvary, he hung and bled unto the sixth and an eighth hour. But early one Sunday morning, he got out the grave with all power in his hand. See, sometimes as a young generation, we feel like mama don't know nothing. We feel like daddy and mama ain't been through nothing. But what you gonna do when mama and daddy's gone? Because they tried to point you in the right direction, but you chose the wrong direction. Then you look back in life and said, well, I wish I should have listened to mama. Then you realize when mama tried to talk to you, when mama tried to talk to the daughter didn't want to listen. Well, then father tried to talk to the son, then father, then son didn't want to listen. I'm reminded today of an old song by a songwriter named Willie Banks. He said, you'll die young if you don't take the time out to listen to your parents. Well, later back then, he came back and wrote a song. It was about a little girl. She said, Lord, please give me one more chance. How many of y'all know you're crying right now to Jesus? You could be on your deathbed, went to some place you wasn't supposed to go. You realize it was wrong, but God brought you out just like he did with the Hebrew boys in the fiery furnace, with Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego. Well, God is the right direction. I don't know about you today, but if I were you, I'd take God in my hand. I'll take the right direction. I will move on and move out the wrong direction, because I was on my way to hell, but I had to find out that Jesus is my refuge. He's my soul. He's my rock. He's my shield. He's my everything. When I find myself can't think, I feel like everybody don't know who I am. I just go down on my knees in my prayer closet, go to that right direction. I look to the left. I look to the right. I looked everywhere, my friends. They were nowhere to be found. Whether you were strung out on cocaine, strung out on drugs, or you had your child, you feel like they talked about you. But there's one man I know that's the right direction. He sits high and he look lower. He may not come when I want him, but he's the right on time. He's right on. Right on time. Anybody know Jesus ever to come in your room? Ever to heal your body when you've been sick? Ever to move mountains when it did not look like there was no food on the table? Made a way out of nowhere. That's the right direction. I want you to look over and say, neighbor, what direction are you gonna go? I'ma take Jesus' hand. I don't know about you, but the right direction is where I wanna go. Well, you see John in the book of John. Well, in the book of Proverbs, the third chapter, the fifth verse, trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not unto thy own understanding. Direct God, but you can't direct God because you ain't God. Well, you got to follow the right direction. You gotta follow the right direction. Follow the right direction.
well, you don't know it all. If you got a mother, appreciate her while she's here, because tomorrow might be too late. Well, I'm reminded today of a funeral I went to back in 2019 or 13 or whatever it was. But I saw father and sons buried in the same casket. They was in a car wreck. They got hurt so bad they did not make it. But well, don't you know, God got a way of bringing you down when you least expect it. When folks think they this and that, when you think you gotta go out, you think you gotta party, you think you need the wrong direction, or the wrong direction help you if you get in trouble, will it be there for you when you get sick? Will God come right in and there for you? The Bible said, I was hungry and you gave me food. I was naked and you clothed me. I was sick and you came to visit me. Well, God is a good God. Ain't he all right? Oh, ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Where should I go? I'll go to the Lord. I could go to the Lord. When everybody say I don't know, you just tell them these words. I could go to the Lord. Every time it look like bills ain't right, where you can go, I can go to the Lord. I won't complain, but I can go to the Lord. I can go to the Lord. I can go to the Lord. Tired of being wrapped up, tangled all up in your situation. You feel like you want to go to God. You feel like you need to go to Jesus. Well, God is still saving. God is still saving. Oh, yes, he is. Back in 2013 of January, when I gave him my life, I realized I didn't want to do what mother said. I used to talk back, didn't want to help with the dishes, didn't want to do nothing. But the Bible said, a disobedient child won't live long. I think about I could not have had my mother, but God let her live to see another day. Sometimes we take life for granted, until it's our own life. Sometimes we take our own health for granted, until our own health. Where could I go? Amen. Where could I go? Where could I go? Where could I go? No other help from nobody. Thank you, Lord.
blessed that it fall upon good ears, not stony ground bears, and you bless the people that are free as you bless the viewers that about to view as you bless the families. Lord, bless all 48 subscribers of this channel that they will receive this doctoring. Lord, I pray that you bless each and every family, Lord, each and every state, each and every governor, each and every president right now, Father God. I pray that you bless our economy. Lord, bless us right now, Father God. We thank you for just giving us the strength to breathe in and breathe out, Lord, as you grant us this day.